Der Täter dieses Falles. Die Person, die in diesem Exisal ist. Es kann nur diese Person sein. Nun, dann wäre nur noch Kaito übrig.
The apparent victim we saw in the video was Kaito, which means... Kokichi was operating the hydraulic press and camera at first. If the two of them switched while the press was stopped, then the culprit who started the hydraulic press again and crushed Kokichi must be Kaito.
Dann wäre es wirklich Kaito.
So, the person inside that exosol isn't Kokichi. It has to be Kaito.
What did you say?
So, the culprit for this case is Kaito Momota. That is what the ultimate detective has deduced, right?
Ja, anscheinend.
Kaito is the culprit? What? You're joking, right? You can't be serious.
I don't want to believe it either. But it's the only way any of this makes sense. My detective work has led me to the conclusion that Kaito is the culprit. Is that true? Is Kaito really in there?
I'm the culprit.
Maki ist die Täterin? Huh?
There's just no way that Kaito can still be alive. Because I'm the culprit.
Wait, you? But didn't you say...
I saw it with my own eyes. Kokichi drank the antidote that he stole from Kaito. There's no doubt Kaito died. And he died because of my poison arrow.
Kaito ist gestorben wegen dieses Pfeils, oder wohl eher wegen des Giftes.
But you told us you didn't want to kill Kaito.
Yes, I never wanted to. I wanted to believe that I didn't kill him. But the truth speaks differently. In the end, I was just running away from the facts.
I don't understand.
Maki. Versuchst du, Kaito zu beschützen? Wenn er der Täter ist, warum versuchst du ihm dann zu helfen?
There was only one antidote, so it's more likely he died from my poison arrow. This is the truth.
It's not decided yet. I could have still killed him with the hydraulic press. Either way, those are the two options. Monokuma knows the answer, right?
Huh? Are those the only options?
I guess that's how things turned out.
No, that can't be. The person in that exosol is...
It's not Kaito. I saw Kokichi drink the antidote. There's no mistake. Kaito is dead. I killed Kaito.
Maki hat Kaito umgebracht.
There is absolutely no doubt. That's...
Ah, okay, ich dachte es mir. Maki versucht, Kaito zu beschützen. Ich verstehe, wie sie sich fühlt, aber wenn Kaito der Täter ist, warum hat er dann Kokichis Plan zugestimmt? Ich kann mir nicht vorstellen, dass Kaito etwas so Selbstsüchtiges tun würde. Es muss einen Grund dafür geben. Ich glaube das wirklich.
But Maki, you don't know for certain that Kokichi drank the antidote.
What?
You saw him drink it right in front of you, but you couldn't confirm he actually did it. So maybe there's another possibility.
What are you talking about?
Hat Kokichi vielleicht gar nicht dieses Gegengift getrunken?
Impossible. That's impossible. There is no other possibility. I killed Kaito!
Oh shit, oh no. Fuck. Ich kann doch diesen Scheiß hier nicht, Alter. So. Dreieck, Kreis, Viereck meine ich natürlich. Aber okay. Ja, also Maki hat ja gesehen, dass dass Kokichi das Gegengift gibt. Ich kann gar nicht mehr reden, Alter. Es geht ja alles schon so lang, verdammt nochmal. Ist das die längste Klassenverhandlung ever? Außer halt bei dem Finale, kann fast schon sein. Kam auf jeden Fall sehr, sehr lang vor. Kann ich hier nicht irgendwie... Warte mal. Hier, genau, das hier wollte ich machen. So. Ich darf trotzdem nicht... Selbst wenn ich hier diesen Kram anmache. Fever-Time, ey. So, so, so. Boah, die hat auch so verdammt viel HP, Alter. Das kann ja noch eine Stunde dauern, ey. Aber... Maki hat ja gesehen, dass Kokichi das Gift getrunken hat. Aber... das Gift, Alter. Das Gegengift getrunken hat. Aber vielleicht gibt es noch eine weitere Wahrheit hier, die wir bedenken sollten. Dieses Kapitel war auf jeden Fall durchaus schwieriger als das normale als ein normales Kapitel, aber das war zu erwarten. Ich meine, wie gesagt, vor einigen Parts habe ich es glaube ich schon mal gesagt, aber wir nähern uns ja dem Ende, deswegen, ja, sollte man wohl damit rechnen, dass es hier nicht leichter wird, sondern schwieriger. Wenn ihr euch auch mal zurückerinnert an Kapitel 5 aus Danganronpa 2, das war ebenfalls nahezu unlösbar. Auch wenn wir es dann trotzdem noch krass gefunden haben. Alter, was ist denn das hier für ein Shit? Ich treffe hier echt gar nichts mehr. So, Dreieck, Dreieck, Kreis, so. Ist auch so nervig, dass dieser Kram hier durch die Gegend fliegt, ey. Man wird sich denken, macht eigentlich gar nichts aus, aber irgendwie ja doch. So, hier nochmal Fever Time anmachen. Vielleicht haben wir es dann auch schon geschafft. Auch wenn Maki ihn beschützen möchte, glaube ich, dass vielleicht doch Kaito hier der Täter war. Boah, ich kann diesen Rhythmuskram echt nicht, ey. Dass wir das auch immer wieder einbauen müssen. Natürlich gehört das mittlerweile dazu, aber trotzdem. Da bin ich nicht wirklich dankbar drüber.
I saw Kokichi drink the antidote.
Vielleicht hat Kokichi nur so getan, dass er das Gegengift trinkt.
Kokichi just pretended to drink the antidote. He didn't actually drink it.
He pretended to drink it?
Drinking the antidote was part of his lie. Maki could only see so much through the window. She didn't confirm Kokichi drank it. I believe that Kokichi knew this and just pretended to drink the antidote. After Maki left, he gave the antidote to Kaito.
Und nachdem Maki dann weg war, hat er das Gegengift Kaito gegeben.
There's a strong possibility that all of this was done to make Kaito cooperate. We can cooperate.
Und Kokichi wollte wohl, dass Kaito mit ihm zusammenarbeitet?
The swapping trick required the victim and culprit to work together. Kaito's cooperation was essential to Kokichi's plan. However, I don't think Kokichi would be able to sway Kaito easily. He needed leverage. He gave Kaito the antidote in exchange for his cooperation.
Und dafür hat er dann Kaito das Gegengift gegeben.
In exchange for his own life, you mean?
Kaito had no choice. He had to cooperate after Kokichi saved his life. That's just Kaito's character. And Kokichi knew that. He swallowed his pride with the antidote and agreed to participate in Kokichi's plan.
But didn't Kokichi make this plan? What good is it for him if he's dead?
I imagine this was all part of Kokichi's plan to confuse us. You wouldn't think that someone would plan their own murder.
Ja, eigentlich nicht, aber...
He went so far as to give up his life. Just to create this mystery?
Only Kokichi could think of something so nefarious. Who else would agree to die, just to execute their plan?
Nagito zum Beispiel.
Why would he go that far?
I bet Kokichi was determined to beat me at my own game, no matter what. But too bad! Shuichi figured out the truth!
Are you sure it's not delusion?
Delusion?
A delusion completely off the mark. To make you think that I died.
Oder haben wir vielleicht doch Unrecht?
But who cares what you guys think? This is between me and Monokuma. I don't give a crap if the extras in this game get it right or not.
Extras? I'm fine with being an extra.
Himiko, du bist glaube ich wirklich nur so ein Nebencharakter, ne? Also, ich kann's da schon verstehen.
Huh? Why? If we're just extras, then even if we get it wrong, we won't get killed.
No, I'd still kill you all. Don't put Kokichi's words in my mouth.
Ah, okay. Danke dafür. Ich hab's dir gesagt, Himiko, gewöhn dich nicht dran, ne?
If Monokuma gets it right, then he takes everyone's lives, yeah? But if Monokuma gets it wrong, then he'd have no right to take everyone's lives. If Monokuma doesn't know who the culprit is, then this killing game can't function anymore.
Dann könnte dieses Killing Game nicht mehr funktionieren.
Kaito, I believe in you.
Wenn du mit Kokichi zusammengearbeitet hast, dann muss es dafür einen Grund geben. Um diesen Grund herauszufinden, muss ich die Wahrheit enthüllen.
I still think Kaito is the culprit. Thinking of it that way makes all the pieces fit. I will show you the truth. The truth you can't deny.
Nun, es ist dann wohl mal an der Zeit für das Closing Argument. Und das hier war, wie bereits gesagt, ein ziemlich schwieriger Fall. Was haben wir denn hier überhaupt am Anfang direkt mal zur Auswahl? Die Blutspur. Der Exisal. Die Elektrobombe. Und das Gegengift. Wo fangen wir jetzt am besten mal an? Um ehrlich zu sein, ich habe keine Ahnung. Dieser Fall ist so verdammt verwirrend, wie ich finde. Hier haben wir das Gegengift. Das hier müsste dann das sein, ne? Okay. Was haben wir hier noch? Versuchen wir es mal hier mit der Elektrobombe. Wann wurde die Elektrobombe denn eingesetzt? Hier nach, oder? Warte, hier war das hier mit der Blutspur, ne? Genau. Was haben wir da noch? Der Exisal, die Elektrobombe. Nee. Wann genau wurde die Elektrobombe eingesetzt? Ich habe keine Ahnung, du. Das muss das gewesen sein, oder nicht? Okay, gut. Dann haben wir jetzt hier noch... Ich weiß halt nicht, was damit gemeint ist. Ach so, als er den Exisal übernommen hat mit dem Hammer. Ah, okay, okay. Ich war gerade etwas verwirrt. Wo war das jetzt genau? Das war nicht das hier. War sie schon davor? Ach, ich kann noch weiter zurück. Ach so, ach so, ach so, okay. Das war nicht das hier. Das war das hier. So, damit hätten wir jetzt was Neues frei... Oder nicht? Achso, hier haben wir noch was. Okay. Das war das, wo Maki in den Hangar gekommen ist, ne? Das muss also das hier gewesen sein. Mit dem Exisal. Jetzt haben wir hier einige weitere Sachen freigeschaltet. Das hier und das hier. Das hier oben auch noch? Ja, okay. Kokichi in der Presse oder unter der Presse. Das wäre hier ja ganz am Ende dann, ne? Oder hier. So. Das hier wäre das, als Kaito noch unter der Presse war. Dann die Armbrust. Das war ja schon davor. Das muss hier irgendwo gewesen sein. Oder? Oder hier? Was lasse ich schon... Hier. Nee? Hä? Ach so, hier, okay. Da war ich noch ein kleines bisschen... zu früh dran. Oder wohl eher zu spät. So, das Gegengift kam dann etwas später. Das wäre dann hier gewesen, ne? So. Und dann wären wir jetzt bei den letzten Hinweisen, die wir noch hier haben. Und nicht Hinweise, sondern wohl eher diese Panels, die ja noch eingefügt werden müssen. So, was haben wir jetzt hier? Okay, der erste Schuss. Der, wo ging nochmal der... Ich weiß doch die Reihenfolge nicht, Alter. Fangen wir mal mit dem anderen Kram an. Der rechte Arm, drei Pfeile. Okay, das hier kommt ganz am Ende, dass die Klamotten runtergespült wurden bei der Toilette. Oder in der Toilette wohl eher. Die drei Pfeile kamen dann wohl am Anfang noch irgendwo. Die muss er ja irgendwo aufgenommen haben. Nee. Wo hat Kaito zuerst hingeschossen? Wahrscheinlich den Arm. Es wäre ja schwierig, in den Rücken zu schießen, ne? Genau. So, dann kommen wir jetzt hier hin. Und der erste Schuss von Maki ging in den Rücken von Kokichi. Der zweite Schuss ging dann in den Arm von Kaito. Das wäre hier. Und dann wäre noch eine Sache hier übrig. Das wäre dann das hier. Diese drei blutigen Pfeile.
This is the truth of the case. Let's go over the trick that Kokichi and the culprit created together. Last night, Kibo saw Himiko from the window of his lab. She was carrying a black case and heading to the Exosol hangar. When she reached the hangar, she handed the case to someone through the bathroom window. That someone is the culprit of this case. Locked in the bathroom, the culprit had asked Himiko to bring them a certain weapon. A disassembled crossbow from Maki's lab. The culprit was going to use the crossbow to challenge Kokichi to a fight. Some time passed, and Maki made her way to the hangar. She was going to the hangar to kill Kokichi and save the culprit trapped in the bathroom. However, the hangar had an electric barrier preventing her from entering. Fortunately for her, she had an electro hammer to get around the barrier, in a way. She used her electro hammer to disable an exosol and climbed inside. She knew exosols could bypass the barrier, so she got inside one. Around that time, the culprit and Kokichi began their confrontation. While Kokichi was checking up on them, the culprit ambushed him with a crossbow. But the culprit didn't intend to kill Kokichi. They just wanted to disable him. That's why the culprit aimed for Kokichi's right arm. If they really wanted to kill him, they would have shot him in his vitals. Kokichi reeled from the arrow, and the culprit jumped on him immediately. He didn't want Kokichi to have the chance to summon an exosol with a remote. While they were fighting, something happened that caught them both off guard. The shutter of the hangar opened, and an exosol stepped inside. Kokichi was definitely not expecting an exosol to interrupt them. He pulled out his remote in an attempt to control the exosol. But Maki leaped out of the cockpit and shot Kokichi with her crossbow. The arrow hit Kokichi right in the back, and it was no normal arrow. The tip was covered in a lethal poison from my lab called Strike 9 Poison. The poison kills slowly. It seems as if Maki wanted Kokichi to confess before he died. But even with poison in his veins, Kokichi continued to spin his lies. When she had had enough, Maki tried to finish him off with another poisoned arrow. But this time, Maki was the one caught by surprise. To keep Maki from becoming the Black Imp, the culprit used their body to shield Kokichi. The culprit's left arm was struck by a poison arrow. Maki remembered that there was an antidote in my lab and immediately ran off to get it. The Strike 9 poison slowly circulated through their systems and would soon kill them both. But in that desperate situation, Kokichi thought up a clever lie. He incorporated this unforeseen event into his plan to help him win the killing game. Or should I say, help him defeat Monokuma.
That was Kokichi's true objective. It's why he claimed to be the mastermind. Thinking fast, Kokichi closed the shutter so that Maki could not re-enter the hangar. Thus, Kokichi's final lie was set into motion. When Maki returned with the antidote, she couldn't get back inside the hangar. So she went around to the hangar bathroom and passed the antidote through the window. But after the culprit was given the antidote, Kokichi immediately snatched it. Kokichi drank down all of the antidote while the culprit and Maki watched in horror. Maki must have been panicking, thinking the only antidote was now gone. She believed that the culprit was going to die from her own poisoned arrow. But it was all another one of Kokichi's lies. He had only pretended to drink the antidote. Maki tried desperately to break into the hangar, even slashing the control panel. But she couldn't get the shutter to open again. Defeated, she had no choice but to leave. After Maki had left, Kokichi took out another weapon. An electrobomb, capable of disabling communication devices for hours. Kokichi's plan was to use an electrobomb to knock out Monokuma's surveillance cameras. That was why he commissioned Mew to make the bombs in the first place. After detonating an electrobomb, Kokichi coerced the culprit into drinking the antidote. In exchange for the antidote, Kokichi asked the culprit to cooperate with his plan. Kokichi needed to work with the culprit to execute his final lie. Under normal circumstances, the culprit would never have agreed to such a plan. But because the culprit owed him for saving their life, they agreed to Kokichi's request. Request is a generous term. It was more like blackmail. In any case, the two were now working together as accomplices in an insane plan. There was a lot to prepare and not a lot of time. They had to work fast. If Kokichi died from the Strike 9 poison, the whole plan would be ruined. After fabricating the scene in the bathroom, the culprit dragged Kokichi to the hydraulic press. This is how the swipe pattern bloodstain from the bathroom to the press was created. Kokichi, with the support of the culprit, stood in front of the press's control panel. The two of them were finally ready to execute the insane lie. While Kokichi was setting up the video camera near the hydraulic press's control panel, the culprit laid face up inside the press, draping their coat over their shoulders. Then, Kokichi activated the press and the camera's record button at the same time. The press came down slowly, all caught on tape for us to see. Normally, the safety function would have triggered, but the electrobomb had disabled it. The press got lower and lower, and just as the culprit disappeared from view, Kokichi pressed the force stop button and the camera's pause button simultaneously. The two then switched places, and also switched roles. The culprit and the victim. The would-be victim became our culprit, and started up the press and camera. Kokichi had saved the culprit's life because his trick required their cooperation. He wanted to win the killing game, even if it meant dying himself. And so, Kokichi was crushed by the press, and the whole thing was caught on video. The culprit's left sleeve was dangling from the press, making us think he was the victim. Now alone, the culprit collected the video camera and tore the hydraulic press's power cord so that it could never be raised again. This would make it impossible for us to determine the identity of the crushed body. But there was another reason the victim was killed in this way. It obfuscated the cause of death, making the case that much more difficult to solve. This was all part of Kokichi's plan to create a murder not even Monokuma could figure out. With the press disabled, the culprit returned to the bathroom to flush Kokichi's clothes. Finally, they climbed inside of an exosol to hide and waited with bated breath. And here they are now in this trial, pretending to be Kokichi. They're trying to deceive Monokuma in order to defeat the true mastermind. And that's it. That's Kokichi's unidentified culprit trick. The culprit is in that exosol. It's you, isn't it? Kaito Momota, the ultimate astronaut.
Und das wäre wohl die ganze Wahrheit hier.